as we continue to cruise through the bay here. Now the A shape there, known as an anticline, the V shape formation, a syncline. And together here they comprise what geologists call a chevron fold. Chevron fold. This is a great example to show you that a rock can bend, buckle, and fold without actually breaking or cracking, fracturing, that kind of thing. And a great example of the mountain building process, or mountain erosion, as it's sometimes called. Mountains and valleys being formed due to that buckling or rippling effect. Pretty neat chevron fold. You can find those in other areas of the park here, but very rarely will you find one that compact in size and easy to see. Usually they're on a much larger scale and a little difficult to pick out for the untrained eye. Also, looking at that cliff, you can see some vibrant orange color to the rock. That's not the rock itself. That's actually a living organism growing here. It's called lichen. It's kind of like a moss. What it actually is, it's a symbiotic relationship between an algae and a fungus. These two different organisms coexist together, grow on the rock. And we have a great variety, number of species here, number of types here in the area, variety of different colors as well. As far as colored rock goes in this area, we have an abundance of red and green colored rock. And if any folks have taken the drive up to Red Rock Canyon, you know what I'm talking about. The entire canyon is made of that rusty red colored rock. If you haven't been there yet, you have a little more time here in Watertown, I would highly recommend taking the half hour drive up to the canyon itself and just exploring a little bit more of the geology as well. The red and the green that we have here, both are part of the Argillite or Grinnell formations. This is sometimes called. It's a sedimentary rock of mudstone with a very high iron content. And while this rock was being laid down and formed, if there was oxygen present during that time of formation, the iron would oxidize, turning that gaudy, rusty red color, specifically known as hematite. Now the green is just the opposite. It was never exposed to oxygen during its forming period, and that's known as chlorite. So hematite's the red, chlorite is the green. Remember that, it's on the test.
So that's it for the
remember the green.
One other thing I'll mention about the geology here, when geologists came up here originally to date the rock, they discovered something pretty unusual. And that was the fact that we found this layer of rock, 1.2 billion year old rock, found the tops of our mountains. The younger layers were found below as they went down into the mountains. This is pretty unusual because we think of this sedimentary rock being formed. It all initially starts off with the deposition of sediments. So over a huge time span, sediments are brought down through river systems and tributaries, and all the sediment is deposited in a basin of some sort. And over thousands and millions of years, layer upon layer will build up over time. So you'd think the oldest layers are deposited first, and younger layers eventually will build up on top of that. And that's always the case, but not the case here. And this is due to a fault line just to southwest of this location known as the Lewis Overthrust, the Crust Fault. So what happened here at a very low-lying angle, the oldest bottom layers of rock were thrust upwards on top of the younger.